This is Jessica Sweeney with Timefire VR, and I will show you how I make paint splatters in Substance Designer. The goal of this is to create a reusable SPSAR that I can apply on top of any mesh inside of Substance Painter. If we open up the graph, you can see I organized it by my reference, shapes, color, and outputs. The best part of using Designer is that there are 100 ways to achieve a similar or even better effect. When working on anything, I always start by finding a reference that helps guide my work. In this case, I'm looking for references that show the color, pattern, and textures of paint. If we look at the bottom left example, we can see watercolor splatters and droplets. The top two examples show more oil paint-like blotches and paint smears. The bottom right example will be used to sample colors. If we dig into the graph, I break down my shapes down into splatters, blotches, and smears. With splatters, I take a grunge map, tile it, and then I will use a histogram scan to affect the intensity or visibility of the splatters. This will eventually be an exposed parameter for my SPSAR. Blotches work in a similar fashion, utilizing a different grunge noise mask. I tile the grunge map again to get more noise on my material and use a histogram scan's position and contrast to affect the intensity. I blended additional noise to create additional variation in my normal and roughness maps. Again, for smears, I use another grunge map, but this time I use a directional warp and blur to affect how I want the smeared paint to look. More nodes were used to create some variation, and lastly, a histogram scan again, which will be an exposed parameter. Now onto color, let's start by defining the color for the splatters by enabling the histogram scan for the splatters. For all of my color maps, I use a gradient map to get a large amount of random colors fairly quickly. If we go back to our reference, we can use that to pick our color gradient. I added an HSL to expose later for flexibility. For this example, I wanted very vibrant colors, but you can easily change your values to suit your purpose. Lastly, I used a blur node to create more of a watercolor instead of a marble effect for my base color output. This could also be exposed depending on the desired result. Now I'll speed up the part where I make other shapes visible, like blotches and smears. I connect my shape to my color using a blend, inputting the color into the foreground and the shape into the opacity. The blending mode is set to copy and the opacity is set to 1. The final step in Designer is to expose parameters to create my SBSAR for use in Painter. We're going to expose the position in this histogram scan and call it Splatter. We're also going to expose a contrast and call it Splatter Contrast. You can name these whatever you want, as long as it makes sense to you. Now I'll go through and expose the rest of the shape histogram parameters in a similar fashion. After exposing shapes, I go through and expose each HSL in color. We can export out our SBSAR file for use in Substance Painter. I called this Paint Grunge, but feel free to name it whatever you want to. In Substance Painter, I imported some of the meshes from the team into the scene and applied their textures. In the material shelf, we can see our Paint Grunge and apply it to our material. Here I enabled color and height, and you can see the parameters we exposed previously in Designer. Here's the final example scene where I use a paint splatter SBSAR to various meshes in order to quickly create variations. Thanks for watching this tutorial. The best part of Substance is that there's many ways to accomplish this effect. Let us know what you thought below, and subscribe for more videos like this one from the Timefire VR team.